Alright, let's make some Motorhead badges for your vehicle.
My name's Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber. A little while ago, I got a new hybrid vehicle, and those of you who have been following me on social media know this already. The thing is this manufacturer has never sent me any money for advertising for them, so I took their badges off my car. The irony of the loudest band on the planet and the quietest vehicle is not lost on me. It is kind of funny. Anyway, starting the project, I'm going to build the logos or the badges in Fusion 360. I got a little Motorhead logo here, and I put it on an oval, and I'm just extruding it out. What I really like here is that the logo is flat and the badge is curved, and I love how it sort of protrudes in the face of the wind, kind of like the band does. Both logos are different sizes, so they did require different CAD models for each one. I printed them on my 3D printer, and now it's time to finish the badges. So they're all going to get several coats of primer. I usually put about three coats of primer on stuff that I'm making a model of, which is essence is what this is. I always wet sand my stuff, mainly for safety. All the dust goes down the drain. I don't have to wear a mask. So I wet sand, put another coat of primer on, wet sand that down. I'm trying to achieve a really nice finish. On top of that, I'm adding a coat of white primer and sanding that down just as kind of a base coat. And remember, always use a sanding block. As a safety precaution, make sure you're always wearing a mask when you're spraying paint. Here's a second coat of primer. And now I'm gonna mount these parts, and I'm using a little bit of what's called Quake Hold. It's a museum wax. And I'm just using that to mount some blocks onto some yogurt containers here, and then the badges on top of that. This gets the badges off the cup so that I don't have any paint that will set between the paint and the cup. So there's no weirdness that's going to happen there. So a new gloss coat on the badge. Now this is the front badge that gets white. The back one is painted black. Something I want to stress about spraying paint, and I see so many people screw this up, is read the directions on the can. In general, you're going to want to do a couple light coats, preferably to heavy coats. The light coats are going to dry a little bit quicker. You're going to get a much more even coat that way, and much less chance of screwing things up. I'm using a silver paint marker here on top of the black base coat that I'm laying down. I did some tests to make sure I wouldn't have any issues on top of the lacquer paint. I'm using the same brand marker for the white badge. This is a black metallic that I'm using, and I find that quite appropriate for this badge. I do want to note that I did a lot of testing about the best way to paint the top faces of the letters. I tried brushes, but this really worked out the best with the paint marker. Now I'm going to use two coats of clear, and I want to stress again using a mask. I'm wearing an organic vapor mask here as opposed to the little dust mask I was wearing earlier. This is the correct mask to be wearing when you're spraying paint. I'm pulling the badges off the cans here. You can see what they look like kind of raw before they get installed. Now we're going to put them on the vehicle. I'm removing the CMS Rex sticker off the front of my car first, because that's what I've been driving around with for quite some time. I have to snip off a little bit of the grill there, here and there. I drill some holes so that the glue can ooze through a little bit, just to give me a little bit better of a connection. And putting everything together, I'm using a goo automotive paint. It's meant for all weather, and I think it's going to be really suitable for this badge. It's not going to be super brittle. It's going to withstand the warm and the cold temperatures. On the back, I'm doing the same thing, drilling some glue holes, snipping off a little bit of these little clips so the badge fits a little bit better, putting the glue in and pressing that in place. I did end up putting some tape or some weight on these badges and letting them set overnight. Don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. You can click on the little icon on the bottom right of the screen to do that. You can follow me on Twitter, Facebook, and Google+. Rock on. Click here to watch some of the other design and making videos that I have. If you'd like to have your music featured in one of my videos, drop me a line.